president's focus may be on Asia, but earlier today he surprised many by weighing in on the future of the web. The subject, net neutrality, or the idea that all traffic on the web should be treated equally. It's been the focus of a major battle for years as the Federal Communications Commission must decide how to treat broadband providers. Some of the biggest ones have argued there's a place and a need to offer premium service at a different price while still maintaining vital access for all. The White House released a video in which the president made his most direct comments yet about how he thought the FCC should proceed.
They should make it clear that whether you use a computer, phone, or tablet, internet providers have a legal obligation not to block or limit your access to a website. Cable companies can't decide which online stores you can shop at or which streaming services you can use, and they can't let any company pay for priority over its competitors. To put these protections in place, I'm asking the FCC to reclassify internet service under Title II of a law known as the Telecommunications Act. In plain English, I'm asking them to recognize that for most Americans, the internet has become an essential part of everyday communication and everyday life.
We get a deeper explanation of the president's move and look at the reaction to it with Megan Smith. She is the chief U.S. technology officer at the White House. Megan Smith, welcome to the NewsHour. I think the first question is, why is the president making, I think what some are saying, is an unprecedentedly strong statement of his own views about how the internet should operate?
Thanks, Judy. Yes, it's important to note that the FCC has already received 3.7 million comments from Americans, and today the president is adding his voice to that. Net neutrality is such an important principle for the web and for the internet. It's how the internet has operated for all this time. And so we just want to make sure that that stays very clear as we advance into the future.
Well, let me read you some of the comments that have been pouring in today.
Sure.
From some folks who are concerned about this. The former chairman of the FCC, he's now president of the National Cable and Telecommunications Association, Michael Powell, he issued a statement saying, quote, "We are stunned the president would abandon the longstanding bipartisan policy of lightly regulating the internet and call for extreme regulation."
Yeah, it's interesting, some of those reactions. I've seen that some of those as well. This principle of net neutrality is how the internet has been operating since the beginning. And so the FCC has the opportunity here to just put that into practice with moving to Title II. So there's not some kind of extreme regulation being added here. The most important thing is we really want to make sure the American people are able to get to any website they'd like to get to. Let's say, for example, you wanted to reach a couple different video providers. You don't want one of those providers to be able to pay extra so that they can get to you faster and others are slower. You want the internet to operate just as it operates equally across all that. Also, can you imagine if you're making a brand new startup and there's one or two of you in a garage, you want to make sure that that website can get to you just as fast as a website from a very powerful company. It's one of the most important principles of net neutrality, and it's how it's been operating from the beginning.
We're also seeing comments from Verizon. It's calling it a radical reversal of course that would in and of itself threaten great harm to the internet. We have the leading mobile phone association, CTIA, saying imposing antiquated common carrier regulation on the, quote, vibrant mobile wireless ecosystem is a gross overreaction.
Yeah, you know, I'm seeing those too, but it's not playing out in how the internet actually works. One of the things that's interesting is that if you look at Twitter, you see an extraordinary amount of comments on the other side of that. So it's a natural American conversation. What's great is people like Vint Cerf, inventor of the internet, Tim Berners-Lee, Sir Tim Berners-Lee, who's an inventor of the web, very supportive of continuing the web to have the same kind of regulation that it's had the whole time. Net neutrality is very important. For example, if you were on the phone, you wouldn't want your phone provider to, say, stop you from calling Hertz if you wanted to call Avis, or vice versa, Avis versus Hertz. We want to make sure that the internet operates the same way that the phone service operates. And that's what Title II and these telecom regulations make available. And so we can do this lightweight, flexible law for the internet service providers to have them be covered under this law. And then one of the things is it allows for something called forbearance. So there's a long history of these folks not having to have the regulations where they're having price controls or other things like that.
But it is, in effect, the president telling, or at least saying to the independent Federal Communications Commission that this is how he wants it to issue regulations. What does that say about the president's view of the independence of the FCC?
The FCC is an independent regulator, an independent organization, and they'll make a decision. They call for input from across the country, and so the president is weighing in today with a voice. You know, he's been supportive of net neutrality since the very beginning, since he was candidate Obama before he was president. So, again, there were 3.7 million comments that came into the FCC. They're going to be mixing all those different comments together and looking at the opportunities and deciding this themselves as an independent regulator. It's just such an important principle for our economy and for the future and for innovation and for the protection of American people to be able to have access to whatever websites they would like to go to, and for the independence of these fabulous entrepreneurs who've been able to make these incredible websites that have really grown our economy. We want to make sure that that continues strong into the future, and that the ISPs are not able to create, you know, paid toll roads or unfair advantage for different websites and have people pay different amounts.
You say 3.7 million people have weighed in, but you would agree the president expressing his view is a heavier, shall we say, finger on the scale than anyone else's, isn't it?
It's very important, but the FCC is an independent organization, and they're going to look at all the different things in front of them. But the president feels very, very strongly that this is important for our economy, it's important for entrepreneurs, it's important for the protection of the American people, and for the flexibility, of course, in this industry to make sure that we have this lightweight expression of this Title II law available to us to keep the Internet free and open for all American people.
And finally, Megan Smith, some have asked, why is the president doing this now? Is there a reason he waited until after the election to step in?
I'm not a pundit, so I'm not sure about timing in that. But I think really the most important thing is he feels incredibly strongly about this. And these are the times when the FCC is considering these issues. So it's important for he and the rest of the American people to be out there with our voices.
Megan Smith, who is the Chief Technology Officer at the White House, we thank you.
Thank you, Judy.